Commitment 2010 coverage. Tomorrow is Election Day in Kentucky. And the race grabbing national attention is the GOP primary for Jim Bunning's U.S. Senate seat because it seems to pit an establishment favorite against a darling of the Tea Partiers.
Thank you all very much.
Certainly made sense for Trey Grayson to be campaigning today at the Northern Kentucky International Airport, what with concourses closing and jobs taking off faster than flights. But Rand Paul has been pushing a different kind of symbolism, stumping at just folks places like this Perkins Pancake House in Highland Heights.
And I think I'm lucky to be part of the tidal wave that may be coming forward with new people who are not career politicians.
That tidal wave is the informal, relatively unorganized, but perhaps strongly brewed Tea Party movement. Rand Paul's an ophthalmologist who helped his libertarian dad, Congressman Ron Paul, but never held elective office on his own. His opponent is Kentucky's Secretary of State, who's endorsed by respected Republicans from former Vice President Dick Cheney to the Commonwealth's senior senator, Mitch McConnell.
I rarely endorse in primaries, but these are critical times.
Grayson and Paul don't differ a whole lot on most issues. Grayson calls Paul a late convert to clean coal and an isolationist regarding Iraq and Afghanistan. Paul says, unlike Grayson, he opposes earmark spending, even for popular projects like replacing the Brent Spence Bridge.
None of the dollars that have been appropriated for the design and the study of this have been in any president's budget. They've all been earmarked by members of Congress. And that's why I do not support an earmark ban.
So that GOP primary tomorrow may come down to whether establishment backing helps Grayson or backfires, and whether Paul can get his supporters to step up to the table.